the Fellowship of Reconciliation. You're looking at a cover of a comic book produced by the Fellowship of Reconciliation. You see, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was not the first to champion nonviolent protest in America. No, no. The Fellowship of Reconciliation, also known as FOR, has been preaching nonviolence since the early part of the 20th century. Founded at Cambridge University in 1914 by Henry Hodgkin, an English Quaker, and Frederick Siegmund Schultz, a pacifist chaplain to the Kaiser. That's right, he was a pacifist chaplain to the Kaiser. The FOR, F-O-R, was established to promote pacifism and international understanding. The organization opened its first American chapter in 1915. Although the FOR is primarily concerned with the dissemination of intellectual ideas, the majority of its members are students, professors, and ministers. The fellowship does occasionally engage in direct action. The group sponsored the first Freedom Ride in 1941, called the Journey of Reconciliation. This project sent a biracial group of 13 on a bus ride through the Upper South. Later, the FOR played a key role in the Montgomery bus boycott by sending two of its staffers to serve as consultants. The Reverend Glenn Smiley, FOR National Field Secretary, and Bernard Rustin, former FOR Race Relations Secretary. Both worked closely with Dr. Martin Luther King in planning movement strategy. The role that I played with Martin Luther King, Smiley says, was one in which I literally lived with him hours and hours and hours at a time, and he pumped me about what nonviolence was. When the boycott ended, Smiley sat next to Dr. King on the first integrated bus ride through Montgomery. The FOR used a $5,000 grant to put out a comic book, what you're looking at, commemorating the event and popularizing the philosophy of nonviolence. The group distributed some 200,000 copies of the 10-cent booklet. Ironically, the publication reached more university students than the semi-illiterate adults for whom it was originally written for. The FOR and its members have helped create numerous groups that work for social change. These include the American Civil Liberties Union, the National Conference of Racial Equality. Yeah. At the era of the early 90s, FOR had approximately 32,000 members worldwide. So, when you think of civil rights and social equality, remember that there was a group of non-black Europeans and Americans who fought hard for justice for all. So don't judge, and don't forget the folks who cared about equality before it was popular and publicized. Remember the FOR, the Fellowship of Reconciliation. This is real truth. Like, subscribe, and be a genius. Think for yourself.